Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Good morning, myself Sangeeta Devi from JK Jain School, Raipura. To have a more update on our educational videos, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel JK Jain School. And if you like our video, you can like on it. We are seeing about the 11th standard commerce in the last few sessions, also historical background of the commerce in the subcontinent. In today's class also, we are going to continue that. In the last classes, we saw about the different ports which were there and ancient trading centers near the coastal regions we were discussing in the last session. Today, we are going to see about that in the ancient Tamil Nadu trading centers, what is the role of the government. So, here also the role we are going to see that in the ancient Tamil Nadu. So, that topic only we are going to discuss, the role of the government during the ancient Tamil Nadu. So, here we have a different things, different roles they have done. We are going to see one by one in the today's session. First, before going to the role of the government during the ancient Tamil Nadu, first we all want to know about the government. At present, we all know about the government, what is their activities, what they are doing for the people, everything we can know. Likewise, what was the role of the government in the ancient Tamil Nadu, we are going to discuss in the today's session. First, before going on to the trade, we all know about what is the trade. Trade is nothing, it is a buying and selling activities occurring, we tell it as the trade. So, traders are nothing, the person who is involved in the buying and selling activities, we tell them as the traders. Here, we have two different words. Before going on to the role, we have two different words. One was the Yanavar and Jonavar. Okay, two different words we have. So here, Yanavars are the word which were used in the ancient Tamil Nadu. The foreign trader peoples, we tell them as the Yanavars. So from the foreign, whoever the people come for the transacting with the business with the Tamil Nadu people, they have all been called as the Yanavars. Okay, so foreign traders only, the other name we can tell it as Yanavars. Okay, Yanavars are nothing, the people, the foreigners who are transacting the business with the Tamil Nadu people, they called them as the Yanavars. So next we have is the Jonagar. So Jonagar is nothing, the Arab people. In the ancient Tamil Nadu, if you see, there will be a different peoples who has lived. If you see that Sultan and Arabs, where we have a different peoples who has ruled the country. Okay, the king system. Whenever there was a kingdom, in the kingdom rules and all, if you see, there will be a different peoples who were ruling. There will be a Sultan, so there will be a Arab people. Different peoples will be ruling. So, the people of the Arab who is transacting or who is going to have a transaction with the Tamil people, they will be called as the Jonagar. So, you should not think it as a Jonagar as the area or the some other place. Here, Jonagar mentioned is the Arab people who is transacting with the Tamil people. Okay, so the Arab who is going to have the transactions with the Tamil people, they all will be called as the Jonagar. So, these two different words you have to come across to know about the wordings which were used in the ancient Tamil Nadu before going for the role of the government. Why we want to know this different words? Because they called by these names only in the by their government. So, the government knows about the Yanavars, Jonagar only they were using. So, Yanavars are nothing, the foreign traders. Jonagar here we mentioned is the Arab people who is having a transaction with the Tamil people. Here also foreign traders. Foreign traders is the, from the other country, the people will come and have the transactions with our people. Like it can be of, we all there in Tamil Nadu is there in the Indian country. We all know about it. So from the foreigner, it can be of the other country peoples. Okay, it can be of the Japan or it can be of the England or it can be of the China. Okay, there were a different country people. Okay, mainly if you see the foreign traders, the first foreign traders who has found the sea route, the coastal region, will be a Vasco da Gama. We all know about the navigations, how he has used and how he was finding the route. and from the Europe he came. To have what? To have the trading only the people came from there. From there also. If you see Rome, China, Europe, many country people have came here for trading purposes. They want to have the trade over here for the different types of the goods. Where I mentioned in the last class also, if you see in the Pandyan dynasty, where their different goods like a flour, salt, fish, pearls, cereals, many things they want to have the goods being bought for their country peoples. So they will be coming over here to get that all those goods. So many sea routes and other routes also they started founding. From the other country they want to travel over India. At present we all have a different ways. We have a road ways, we have a sea ways, air ways. Anyways, the people can come from the foreign and have the transaction over here. If we have that facility at present. If you see about the older century, before centuries ago, how was the situation? It was they don't have the transportation facility. For traveling, they want to walk a mile. After that, they found some boat. That also in the Pandyan dynasty period, they started crossing. If they want to cross the rivers, they started finding some boat. They will be named in the different names that also we mentioned in the previous session. Timil, Toni, Odambunai, different Padagu. We have different names for the boats that and all will be used by the people to cross the rivers to have the transactions within their country. So within India itself they started finding in the Pandyan dynasty. So from the foreign traders they used some other boat or ships which they made. Navai, Kalam, so there are Vangam, where we have a different things which were used for crossing the country, one country to other country, they used all these things for crossing the oceans. So this is how the foreign traders came to have the transactions with the business with the our country people. That also specifically in the Tamil Nadu. So that they named in the Yanagars. Jonagar, the Arab people who came to the people with the India Tamil people, they want to have the transaction, they will be named as a Jonagar. Okay, so this is all about the two different words. We are going to see about the role of the government during the ancient Tamil Nadu. So what is the role? What is the responsibility? What is the thing the government has contributed for this trading? We are focusing more on this historical background of the commerce about is the trading. How the trading has been happened in the older periods. That only our main focus. So that also specifically, if you see, what is the government role, we are going to see. All we saw about the other things, the country people, foreigner trade came to have the transaction. The Arab people came and have the transaction. Many different things we saw. Now at present we are going to see about our own Tamil Nadu government what has contributed to this. First I have categorized that into the four sections. One is the infrastructure, protection, installed check post, transportation. So these are the four different things which the government has done. First we will see about the infrastructure. What is infrastructure? Infrastructure is nothing for the people. Easier way they have constructed roads, they have a water supply will be given for the public, that we tell it as a infrastructure. So in the older period also the government has given the infrastructure. Infrastructures they have given for the trading purposes. They started building the roads because there were no roads, proper roads for the transportations and all. So what they did, the government has started to build some roads. Mainly they want to have the long roads. Why they want to have the long roads or main roads? Because it should connect the more states, neighboring states and all, it should connect. If you see about the Tamil Nadu, our neighboring states and all, what? We have a neighboring states. Nearby Tamil Nadu, you will have Kerala, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh. So neighboring states, if from Tamil Nadu people wants to travel to the Kerala, they wants to have the road facility, then only the transportations can be done. So the infrastructure, what the government has given, they started building the roads. So that also specifically main roads, which is connecting the different states or the different peoples, we will be telling that. So what the main infrastructure it was given by the government was Peruvali. Okay, Peruvali is nothing, it is a main road. Main road only will be called as a Peruvali. Peruvali is not having a much different meaning and all. Peruvali is nothing, a main road, we tell it in the language Tamil, Peruvali. Okay, so this was the main road which was given, the infrastructure which was given by the government in the ancient Tamil Nadu. Now, next we have is the protection. Yes, obviously protection is very, very important. Why it is important, the protection? In the trading, what is the involvement of the protection is required? We will see first. We all know about the directions, I think. So let me tell you the directions first. North, west, east, south. Okay, why I am telling the directions? I'll tell you the reason. So we have this directions in the, especially where you will have the, if you take it off the Indian map, okay. In the Indian map you will have like this. So if you have that in the western side, that is also particularly over here, in the western side, you will be having a western guards. On the eastern side, you will be having the eastern guards. Okay. So in the western guards, over that side, you will be having a thick forest. Many forests will be there where it is a dense. Dense forest will be present over in the western guards. Okay. In the India's western side, you will have the western guards. Where it will be what? It will be having a dense, a thick forest. So, there in the thick forest, what it will be there? There will be a wild animals. Where animals will be present over in the forest. So, they, if they want to cross over the wild animals and have the trade, it is very difficult. The animals will be killing the mans. Yes, obviously it will be there. So, for that, the protection has been started by the government. What the protection has been given? They started having a roads over the wild forest, that was a dense forest, to have the smooth transaction. So that the animals will not cross the roads or something. So the people will be free to travel over there. So the western gods and all the people will be, more robbers were there. Robbers are the who? There were in the thick forest who is hiding, we cannot find it out at all. In that situation, the robbers will be catching all our trading goods and they will be selling it somewhere else. Okay, robbers are nothing, it is like a thief. They will be stealing all the goods. So, they want to protect it from the robbers that and from the wild animals, which has happened in the western guards. Why western guards? Mostly it was, there was a thick, dense forest. So, in that situation, the government needs to have the protection. The protection needs to be given to the people. The people should not be very fear of the animals. If I cross, the animal will be killing me. They should not have any fear about it. In that situation, the government has taken the step to protect the man from the animals and also from the robbers. Okay, so this is what is the second thing that the government has done the for the ancient Tamil Nadu people. Next we have is the, we will see transportation and then we will see about the installed check post. So transportation is what? Transportation from one area to the other area for traveling, we all have the car, bike, bus. We have a different vehicles to travel. If I want to travel from one area to other area, I have a lot of facilities at present. But if you see in the older period, what is the transportation facility they have? They, in that, oh, the older periods only, they started finding out. They will be having a bullock carts, or some will be where only the wood will be there, that will be carried over with wheels, it will be carried over by the peoples. So it was like a difficult for them to have the goods from one place to the other place. So here let me take it off one example. Somewhere in the city outside, if I have the goods being manufactured, but it needs to be reached to the customer. Customer is that the person who is going to buy. It needs to reach them. In that situation, I want to take the goods from here to there. So there is a transportation requirement is there. So in that situation, if I am not having a transportation facility, my all goods, whatever I manufactured, will be waste. So for that situation, the government has taken a step to have the more transportation facilities to be given for the public, for the people, so that the goods can be taken from over to the other place to avoid that the wastage of the materials. So that was the next step. Next, it was the installed check post. So it was in the older period also, they were started having the check post. Now at present, we all have the toll gates where you will be paying the amount and then only the car or vehicles can be passed on through the and enter the other city. We have a toll gates. Likewise, in the older period, it was installed a check post where all the goods which was going to be brought through the transportation, bullet carts or anything, there will be a check post. They want to pay some amount. That is what is the customs duty. What is the amount they will be paying? They will be paying the custom duty. And then only the goods can enter the other place. Okay. So let me take it as our own example. If it is the Tamil Nadu, the goods are being manufactured. If it wants to go to the Karnataka or Andhra Pradesh, it needs to cross the check post. After crossing this check post only, the goods can be transported to the Andhra Pradesh. So in that situation, they have to pay some amount, that we tell it as a customs duty. So for that, the government has installed a check post to avoid the non-usable goods and all. Okay, which is we have the some other goods which you not use at all. We have some goods. If they are going to transport it, then in the check post they will be caught. So for that purpose, they installed a check post, and also for the government, they should have some revenue or some income. No, so they collected some amount from there as the customs duty. So these are the four different roles which of the government in the ancient Tamil Nadu. One was about the infrastructure. Next, it was the protection from the animals and the robbers. Next was the transportation. So from one area to the other area, the people should be very easily transport their goods. For that, the transportation facilities has been provided. Next was the installed check post to avoid the non-usable goods and all should not be transported. And also for the government, there should be some revenue. For that, they started collecting customs duty. So these all is about the role of the government during ancient Tamil Nadu. So far in the today's session, we were discussing about all the roles of the government and the people from the foreigner, how they are being called, there are people being called in the Tamil Nadu, everything we discussed in the today's session. In the next session, we will be seeing about the important trading centers in the Tamil Nadu. Thanks for watching.